Hello students, in today's video we will prove rule 12 of Boolean algebra. Rule 12 of Boolean algebra is A or B and A or C is equal to A or B and C. So we write it like A or B and A or C is equal to A or B and C. So first we will apply the distributive law. So our left hand side will be equal to A multiplied by A, then A multiplied by C, then B multiplied by A and B multiplied by C. So that will be equal to, that is, we are just solving it like A or A and A or A and C or A and B or B and C. We are just applying the distributive law. So we have applied here the distributive law according to the distributive law. Fine. Then we have A and A is equal to A. So whenever you add a variable with itself, it will be always equal to the variable. It is according to the rule 7. So A and A will be equal to A. All the other terms will remain same, like AC, then AB, then BC. So here we have applied rule. We have applied rule 7. Rule 7 is AA is equal to A. Then, now we have to again simplify it. We will, in the first two terms, wherein we have A or AC, we will take A as a common factor according to the factoring in the distributive law. So it will be equal to A and 1 or C, right? And all other terms will remain same. That will be A, B and B, sorry, or B, C. Okay. So here what we have applied? We have applied the factoring. Factoring in distributive law. Okay. Then we will again write A, but according to the rule 2, if we or any variable with 1, that will be always equal to 1. So 1 or C is going to be equal to 1. That means this is A and 1. This will be equal to A and 1 because 1 or C is equal to 1. So the other terms will remain same. This will remain as AB or BC. So here we have applied rule 2 of Boolean algebra, wherein 1 or C is equal to 1. Then we have A and 1 will be always equal to A. It is again according to rule 4, because whenever we add any variable with 1, that will be always equal to the variable. So it is going to be equal to A plus A B or B C. So here we have applied rule 4 of Boolean algebra, wherein A and 1 is equal to A. Okay. Then we have, here again we can take A out as a common factor from the first two terms, a or ab. So we will be left with a 1 or b, or bc will remain same. So what we have applied? Factoring again. Okay, so this will be equal to, again it will be equal to a, and 1 or b will be equal to 1 according to rule 2 of Boolean algebra, wherein whenever we are a variable with 1, it will be always equal to 1. So I have applied here rule, I have applied here rule 2 of Boolean algebra. Okay, so this is going to be equal to, again 1, a and 1 is always equal to a, that is variable. So I will directly write here a plus b c. So this we have applied here rule 4 of Boolean algebra, wherein a and 1 is always equal to the variable a. So this has proved our rule a plus bc. This is what we have on our right hand side, a plus bc. So prove. Next, we can also prove this rule using the, in a truth table we are going to take variables a, b and c, and then we will first or a or b, and then we will or variable a, c, then a or c multiplied by a or b multiplied by a or c, then b and c, then a or b c. So when we will have, when we will be having three variables, that means we will have 8 combination. That means 2 raised to the power 3, that is 8. So in that case we will be having 8 combinations. So the truth table will be of 8 combinations a, b and c. So first we will, the combinations will be 00001 01 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 1. First we will take a or b. We have to or these two, 0 and a and b. So 0 or 0 will be equal to 0, then 0 or 0 again will be equal to 0, then 0 or 1 will be equal to 1, 0 or 1 will be equal to 1, 1 or 0 will be equal to 1, then 1 or 0 will be equal to 1, 1 or 1 will be equal to 1, 1 or 1 will be equal to 1, will be equal to 0 or 0. So we are doing this a or c, this and this. So 0 or 0 first, 0 or 0 is equal to 0, then we have 0 or 0 again is equal to 0 or 1 is equal to 1, then we have 0 or 0 is equal to 0, then we have 0 or 1 is equal to 1, then we have 1 or 0 is equal to 1, 1 or 1 is equal to 1, 1 or 0 is equal to 1, 1 or 1 is equal to 1. Then we have to take this a or b and a or c. So we have to take and of these two. If one of the bit will be low, the output will be low. So that's what we have to consider in this. So in this column, so it will be 0 here, then it will be again 0 here. So this is going to be 1 and 0, that's 0 again. So 1 1, the output will be 1 here, 1, it will be again 1 1 and 1, because both the inputs are high. So now we have to take b c. Now b and c, we have to AND them. In the AND case, both of the bits or both of the inputs should be high, then only we can get the output as high. So the first will be 0, then 0, then 0, then this will be 1, this will be again 0, this will be again 0, this will be again 0, this will be 1. Okay, now we have to OR this and A. So we will get, if you will OR A with BC, it's going to be like first 0, then again 0, 0, then we have 1, 1, 1, 1 and 1. So if you will consider from here, you will see that this column is equal to this column. The values in both these columns are equal. So we can say that we have proved the rule 12 of Boolean algebra, wherein A or B and A or C is equal to A or B and C.